Welcome back to another video. Now, in this current video, we are going to be addressing the EMSAT Physics and EMSAT Mathematics examination, in which we are going to be selecting every single video as part of a series of videos, a question straight from the EMSAT Math and EMSAT Physics examination. This will help you as part of your EMSAT practice, revision, preparation for your EMSAT examination, whether physics or mathematics. In addition, take a look at the video description where we have very important and useful links for videos which are for our members of the channel, in addition to links to courses and workshops straight on our academy, which have been highly reviewed. Students are enrolling in the courses and they are seeing results. Now, without further ado, make sure that you subscribe and click the notification bell in order to stay tuned with all of these releases for every single upcoming question. Now, let's get right to the problem. So in front of us, we do have an EMSAT mathematics problem. This is related to the algebra part of the EMSAT mathematics, where we need to solve for x. Now in front of us, we do have an equation where we need to find the x in order to make sure that the equation is quite correct. So how do we go about this? The first thing that you need to do, let's write down the problem on this current side, just to make sure that everything is quite clear and systematic. So we have 2 over x plus 3 minus 3 over 4 minus x, which equals to 2x minus 2 over x squared minus x minus 12. Now, this problem could be solved in 2 different ways. I'm going to walk you through the long way because the shortcut is very straightforward. It requires some understanding of the EMSAT tips and tricks, how to go about crushing the actual test. So let's go about this. So the first thing that we need to realize, since we are dealing with fractions, we should make the denominator quite the same. And in order to do so, we should multiply this part by 4 minus x and this part by 4 minus x. And we're going to multiply this part by x plus 3 and this part by x plus 3, which is one of the techniques that you should know how to subtract or add the fractions if they have different denominators. So let's try to simplify this. So if we have the following, 2 into 4 minus x, which is the upper part, over x plus 3 into 4 minus x minus 3 into x plus 3 over 4 minus x into x plus 3 equals to 2x minus 2 over x squared minus x minus 12. Now let's try to simplify this. We have 2 into 4 minus x over. Let's simplify the following denominators and combine them together. So we're going to have 4x minus x squared plus 12 minus 3x. How did I get this? That's what I said. X into 4, that's 4x. Then I have x into x minus x squared. Then we have 3 into 4, which is 12, and 3 into minus x gives me minus 3x. Now let's do the other side. We have minus 3 into x plus 3, and the denominator is exactly the same, which is 4x minus x squared plus 12 minus 3x, which equals to 2x minus 2 over x squared minus x minus 12. Now this looks quite unpleasing since it's quite expanded, so we need to simplify it a bit more. So let's go about this. We're going to say 8 minus 2x,
where I multiplied 2 by 4 and 2 by x over minus x squared. Always keep in mind to arrange it based on the power. Minus x squared. Let's collect the x terms. We got 4x and minus 3x. We end up having plus x plus 12. Minus, we got 3x plus 9 over minus x squared plus x plus 12 equals to 2x minus 2 over x squared minus x minus 12. Now let's collect the fractions together just to make sure we are being systematic. So we do have 8 minus 2x. Don't forget about this minus sign. It has to change the sign for these two. Minus 3x minus 9 over minus x squared plus x plus 12 equals to 2x minus 2 over x squared minus x minus 12. Now I use the different color because this is a very important step as we are almost getting closer to the answer. This step combines the fractions together in order to make sure that we have one side on the left of the equal sign and one side on the right of the equal sign to help us simplify things even more. So what we're going to be doing right now, we're going to carry on with the simplification process. I'm going to say, let's collect the x terms together. We do have minus 5x, and we got 8 minus 9, which is minus 1, over minus x squared plus x plus 12 equals to 2x minus 2 over x squared minus x minus 12. Now you should notice something quite interesting. This is quite similar to this. Is there a way for me to make them look quite alike? Of course I can. Now let's take a look at this. What I'm going to do right now, I'm going to say, let's take the minus sign outwards. So we will have minus 1, because if you multiply by 1 or minus 1, the only thing is going to change the sign. So I'm going to say minus 1 on the side, minus 5x minus 1 over x squared minus x minus 12 equals to 2x minus 2 over x squared minus x minus 12. So notice what I've done here. I took the minus 1 outside, right? Just multiply by minus 1 and flipped the sign. It's like saying, take the minus 1 outside and change all of the signs. So I have x squared minus x minus 12 instead of being plus, plus and a minus over here. Now, what I'm going to do right now, keep this minus 1 at this current time by itself. Now, we notice that the denominator at this current point is the same. This is where I can just simply cross multiply. You multiply this part over here and this part over here, where they are going to cancel out. Make things quite more simple and clear. Now we are going to throw in the minus one that we have taken outside, where we have 5x plus 1 equals to 2x minus 2. We're almost there. Now let's collect the terms. We're going to take the minus 2 this side and the 1 to that side, so we'll end up having 3x equals to minus 3. Minus 2 minus 1 is minus 3. Now, divide by 3, divide by 3, we'll end up having x equals to minus 1. Here we go. And the correct answer is A. So the answer is minus 1. Now, you would realize that the steps are quite numerous as we go about this from the beginning all the way towards the final answer. Now, let's recap what we have done. First of all, we use the rules for subtracting fractions in which we made the denominator the same. This is step number 1. Then after doing so, we made the denominator the same. Then we combined the fractions, keeping in mind if we have a minus sign over here, it should flip the signs for the upcoming terms. Now the collected fractions have been simplified over here, and this is where we have realized that the denominator on the left side is similar to the denominator on the right side, but the only difference is the sign. So that's why I took the minus outside as a minus 1, and then what I've done is I've cancelled or cross multiplied the denominator in the form of cross multiplication, where we are going to cross them out. Then I've returned this minus 1 to help me adjust the signs again, where we have minus 1 into minus 5 and minus 1 into minus 1, where we end up having 5x plus 1 equals to 2x minus 2. This is the simplified form. Then we have solved for x, where we end up with x minus 1. Now, some of you might be wondering, this is quite extensive, whether you have time or not. Well, you do if you know exactly what you're doing, like step 1 step at a time. But let me give you another trick that you can apply. Since we are dealing with solving for x, and you do have all of these options, you can apply the rule of elimination, where you take a look at the problem and try to cross out the answer which does not make sense. First of all, let's take a look at D. Does D work? No real solution. Well, by glancing at the problem, obviously, we can tell that these are factors of this. And x plus 3, 4 minus x, we are able to get solutions. However, this should not be minus 3, and this should not be 4. 4 minus 4 is 0, minus 3 plus 3 is 0. So in order to make sure this is defined, where we have a solution, we should avoid having the answer to be either minus 3 or 4. Other than that, everything should seem quite fine. So this leads us to eliminate this option, which is wrong. Does C make sense? All real numbers. Well, we just said this will not work when x is equal to minus 3, and this will not work when x is equal to 4. So all real numbers is the wrong answer as well. So we end up with having either option A or option B. How can we confirm which one is correct? And this is very simple to do. Let's say you pick up minus 1, go ahead and plug it into both sides of the equation. If both sides give you exactly the same number, it means A is the correct answer. Try to input minus 5 on this side and this side. You will realize that they don't match. But when you input minus 1 on this side and minus 1 on this side in the place of x, and you solve it, you will find out that both sides match. This is another shortcut or a technique that you can use in order to solve multiple choice problems, where if you get stuck, you have no idea what to do, the best thing to do is try to eliminate the wrong choices and try to make an educated guess. So this mainly wraps it up for the current EMSAT math problem.
Now, I truly hope that you found this current question helpful and beneficial. Now, stay tuned for the upcoming releases, in which we are going to have a series, numerous questions that are surely going to support you in terms of the preparation for the EMSAT Physics and Mathematics. Don't forget to take a look at the video description for all of these links related to important courses, workshops, tools, membership videos. Some videos we are going to be releasing addressing key important questions from the EMSAT examination are going to be dedicated for the channel members. So if you're interested in that as well, take a look at the video description for all of these details. In the meanwhile, don't forget to subscribe, click and smash that like button, and I'll see you in the upcoming video.